In the late 90s, the term Web2Print sprouted up. Like any new buzzword, it meant different things to different people. The most basic interpretation was that you could order print processes using a web interface. Upload a print-ready file like a PDF through a browser, specify the quantity, paper type, and other elements, see a price, and click buy. Perhaps before you clicked buy, you'd see a preview of expected output. This represented a serious advance in technology. But more advanced systems would even let you create or edit the document via an online interface. You might do something simple like enter a name and address into fields to produce your own postcard. Or at the other extreme, you could edit a data-driven document template and manage the flow of data through it. That template would ingest a database of recipients and magically produce personalized content. Pioneers in this field, such as Modern Postcard, would let users choose a template, edit it, and upload a data source, perhaps 100,000 targeted postcard recipients, then proof the dynamically generated template-driven output before ordering a large print mail job to thousands or even millions of recipients. For the average printer, Web2Print was at the base level, just ordering the printing of ready-to-print files that were uploaded and emailed. It wasn't necessarily purely web-based. Phone calls might be required. And the next step, online editing, was generally just for one version of a single document. There were, and still are, a number of businesses that thrived on early flavors of Web2Print. Vistaprint, Shutterfly, Modern Postcard, and Magnet Street all represent home run success with early Web2Print. Eventually, the industry converged on a typical workflow and two initial paths. Either you would upload a print-ready file and order print and fulfillment, or edit a document from a template and have it printed and fulfilled. In the most sophisticated offerings, document editing would be tailored to specific use cases, or the template might include variable data. Variable data printing, or VDP, has revolutionized the world of direct marketing. VDP systems from XMPI and other developers can provide intense personalization, where nearly every dimension of a document can be data-driven. Data on age or gender could alter the text or color scheme of each recipient's copy of the document. Layers in the document template can be turned on or off based on the data. If you played roulette, loved steak, and liked jazz music, the targeted one-to-one postcard you received would show exactly that. Response rates to such personalized content could be stunning, if everything aligned. Companies like Chili Publish, Santa Cruz Software, and Silicon Publishing offer end-to-end document editing workflows that enabled non-designers to create documents from templates with web-based editing features rivaling desktop tools. Web2Print continues to evolve to this day, with the website changing more than the print side. Multi-channel publishing was envisioned early on, but only now do we see solutions such as Canva and Figma that span both web and print output. Recent technology advances, such as robust visualization of 3D products and publishing into augmented and virtual reality, are just a few of the exciting new frontiers. Where is it headed? Only time will tell. But the web side of Web2Print is likely to extend along with the advance of fundamental technologies, such as web services and browsers, as well as cutting-edge technologies like extended reality and artificial intelligence. These are exciting times.